city administrator search to order. If we'll stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Kathy, will you take roll, please? Carter, here. Walther?
Here.
Lee?
Here.
Okay. So, kind of going off the notes that we had, that had been created, that Jess had sent to email Kathy in an email after the last meeting. I did listen to the recording. I didn't realize the, based on the recording, it sounded like the agenda had been created. So I didn't type it, but, so.
I'll take the heat for that.
It doesn't matter. So, but, so we're gonna kind of.
We did set up an agenda, yeah, we worked out an agenda.
She just doesn't have it.
But it doesn't exist. It exists on the recording. So, so no big deal, but I, if these were all of the things, was the plan? Because some of this, we can talk about in open session.
Mel, if you don't mind, the plan, tentatively, this is up for discussion, was to go into executive session to discuss the applicants. Then everything else was to be done in open.
Okay, so the first step was to discuss the applicants and then after that, the process of everything?
Well, actually, there was one other step, and that was maybe a tweak on there. Is, was there any other applications that came in that we wanted to consider? If there's not, then go into.
I was told to keep those in a separate file. And I haven't printed them, but there are a few more that have come in.
Yeah, so that's up for discussion, I guess, what we want to do with them.
Well, I mean, I think that we could go into executive session and look at what we have and see if it's, if we want to.
I'm absolutely fine with talking about the ones we've had so far that came in by that last date of the 19th.
Yep.
So I'm perfectly fine with that.
That was our discussion.
It was the discussion in the last meeting.
Focus on these, and if we said, hey, we didn't have anything.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, and I know there was also discussion about closing out the, accepting the applications, further applications, and closing out the job opening. So we can do all that after we go into executive session. So based on this language,
you make a motion?
I'm just trying to figure out where he has it at. It's not the typical. I make a motion to go into executive session pursuant to Ohio Revised Code Section 121.22G1 to consider the appointment or employment of a public employee.
Who else are you going to invite?
I'm going to invite the mayor and Chris. Is that who we had on this? Yes, into this meeting.
I'll second that.
Carter?
Yes.
Walther?
Yes.
Lee?
Yes.
Okay. Executive session at 3:24.
We're going to use your office, is that all right?
That's
right. I already put my stuff in.
I'm used to it.
meeting, they actually had a full house, and it got very, very warm very fast. It was standing room only.
Mel's been sick, so I don't want her to get chilled when she comes out here. I don't know whether she had the flu or a really bad cold or what, but she was been really sick.
Yeah, the flu has been very nasty. Actually, had several school districts, but they closed them for a period of time in eastern Lincoln County.
She's really been down sick. One moves it up, and the other one moves it down.
I've seen her and the Marigoul over it.
Yes. Well, the problem is, you see where she sits? If
right
they
under,
turn the air on to cool it down, she freezes. So do I here.
Yeah. This looks too like it's one of those rooms that was originally not one room, so it probably has dual ventilation systems. And
it's not good. Our in my office, the temperature is usually about 6 degrees colder in there than out here, because
yeah,
it's part of it too. And
yeah, it looks like they chopped up several rooms.
I don't. I've got a little heater, and I turn my heater on, and I don't care what they do out here.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm here to do your fire extinguisher inspection.
Oh,
so.
Okay. Well.
There's a sign. Oh, there it is. I couldn't see it.
No fire extinguishers in my office, so we're good there.
Okay.
Today was council packet day, and Jess isn't here to put things on the website, so Chris is working on that while I'm doing the other packet stuff, and it's been crazy.
As opposed to you would know to have a key to the janitor's closet.
I don't have them. Let me check for you.
Snow, isn't it?
Yeah. Yes. Yep.
Great.
Supposed to start transitioning about now, and then know the rest of you.
Janice over to the finance department.
Okay.
Right across where you come in the front door.
Okay.
They're right there, so.
All right, I'll check, thank you.
Okay. Yeah, there's a gentleman coming over that inspects our fire extinguishers. He's wanting in the janitor's closet.
Oh, okay, well, he was here yesterday. He must be lost.
Well, he
yesterday. Send him over.
He's headed your way, so.
Okay.
All right, bye-bye.
noticed this came over for light snow accumulation.
I never worry about the snow. I'm spoiled. My husband, he was director of public services here for almost 36 years, so
wow.
He plowed a lot of snow. So people worry when we go out on the road and it's bad and we don't think a thing about it.
I guess it was about a week ago, 2 weeks ago tonight, I drove to Granville in a blizzard. And it was, Pataskala roads were fine, but as soon as I got past the LMH Center or so, it just plunged quickly from there and it was just really awful.
We're so used to it, we don't even think anything about it, we just go. He did it for so many years. And back then, he went out in the truck just like the rest of the guys. He didn't stay in the office. You couldn't make him stay in the office. If the stress got bad at work, he went out and patched holes.
I get that, yeah. If you have an option to work outdoors.
Yeah.
When you want to choose to do it, I go for that every time.
He started here when he was 19 years old.
Oh my God.
And retired at 55.
Wow. No one does that anymore. That's job security.
So he started before they had much of anything.
That would be before the merger.
Oh, yes, yeah. Long before the merger.
Yeah.
Merger was in 96, so that was 26 years before the merger.
Jeez. And 36 square miles.
How I started here, with the merger, there was so much work going on, you know, trying to put it all together.
Right.
And I came in and volunteered, and I was volunteering 40 hours a week for a year and a half, and they said, would you take this job? So that's when I became, they had to divide up the finance director the finance director at that time. When they named it that, then they had to separate that from where it was auditor.
Right.
And had to have a separate clerk of counsel. So when that kicked in, then they asked me to do that, so.
Right.
But I was helping him work with grant applications and that type of thing at the beginning of the merger. We had a bridge that went down there by the cemetery. The first 6 months of the merger, that went down.
Really?
And we had to obtain, there was no funding for it, we had to obtain emergency, what they called issue two back then, which was not easy to get, and we got the issue two funding for it, and from the time they closed it till they opened it was 5 weeks.
Really? Wow.
Yes.
They don't do it that way anymore. Yeah.
No.
Bridge widening, they're going to do in Granville. Everyone's living in fear of there, and that's going to be over 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
So.
We used a system, it was called ConSpan. it was prefabricated sections that you brought in and set in place, so.
Right.
That's the reason we were able to do it so quickly.
Trying to get through a creek or a culvert?
It's a bridge. It was a concrete arch bridge.
Wow, huh.
But it was a company called Conspan, and the engineering, the bridge, everything was $214,000.
Wow.
You can't get that. You can't even get engineering for that.
Yeah, you can get an architectural design maybe.
But with that type of, you know, it really cuts your engineering costs, and we had to look for money under rocks at that point. The entire street department budget at that time was only $250,000 for the whole year.
Jeez.
That's labor, materials, everything.
Yeah.
So you can see why we were scurrying to find a way to fund that. And
Yeah, it's nothing.
So that's how I got started.
And how long ago was that?
That was in 96.
So you were on payroll by 98 or so?
June of 97.
Okay. Wow.
But I... There was a lot of inventories that had to be done, sign inventories, and calculations on the number of miles of roads, things they normally would hire an engineering firm.
Mm-hmm.
There was no money for that, so
no.
We went out and worked on that. And one person at the time of the merger said we were going to have $1 million surplus, and Louis said no. They were thinking they would still get some of the things that the county did for the township, that would continue, and it wouldn't.
No.
All your engineering, all your, you know, a lot of the legal services, no, you're not going to get that. And
yeah.
They were sure they were going to keep up with the county roads after the merger, and they said no.
Yeah,
and he told them, don't make it the first day of January.
Right.
And they did, and we got one of our worst winters that year.
Yeah.
He took the county route, did all the county roads that was in the town, and he was determined he was not going to let any of those roads blow closed. And he stayed right on them.
Yeah.
And
you got a few roads in this area, I see, where they do put up hurricane fencing to help with the drifting. It's,
mm-hmm.
You got this much farmland, you're kind of stuck in that position.